This is Trevor Thomas of Koinonia Ministries. I'm dealing with the I Am series, the I Am sayings of Jesus. The first one was, I am the bread of life. The second one is, I am the light of the world. And our scripture is in John 8:12. Again, Jesus spoke to them, saying, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. The journey in the life we live presents twists and turns. The world appears to be good, but you discover you can't trust it. You soon learn of its wicked systems. Without a conviction of God, the very resources of the world will eventually get decimated. For instance, look at the present Eskom crisis with regard to energy. Most places in South Africa are in darkness for over 8 hours a day. Darkness is more the norm than the exception in a technological age that we claim is advancing. Political systems control Eskom, and the very ideology its proponents are prepared to die for has imploded. Their pride has throttled them not to own up to ignorance. A country that has no stiff and rapid penalties for corruptors is a country that will slowly torture its citizens. We are all feeling the brunt of load shedding. In light of this, I offer these 3 points. Christ our inspector, Christ our defender, and Christ our protector. And I shall be dealing with my first point today. Let's look at the first phrase in our text. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Jesus is who he claims to be by calling himself the light, or he must be a lunatic by calling himself the light. And that is a very audacious statement. I am the light of the world. We need some context here. A woman caught in the act of adultery was brought to Jesus to entrap him for his verdict. If Jesus was not the light from heaven, he would have compromised his standards of judgment. He would have judged from the vantage point of the leaders who brought the woman and accused her. But he found them in judgment. They didn't bring the man who together should be charged. Jesus saw right through this. He is the light that penetrates our biases. His light sees through the thicker darkness that accuses the thinner darkness. He saw the woman left for trash in a man's world. As the light of the world, he is the divine inspector. He sees the dark nature of sin. He not only sees it, he is able to inspect it and do something about it. But more than that, Jesus is able to lift you to a better life. He went to the cross to take the rap for any crime and treason you have committed. The reason he could reach out to the adulteress was because he loved her into changing her life. He then forgave her. He finally challenged her to go her way and leave her life of sin behind, because he is able to take care of it. The inspector of life is the savior of life. To save someone beaten by a wicked system takes great compassion. This generation has no compassion. Healthcare services have no compassion. Law and enforcement have no compassion. ESKOM and NERSA have no compassion. Why? Why? They are paralyzed in their dark ideology. They are crippled by Marxist and socialist policies. What exactly is that? Human beings are considered as things. They are abstractions. What is an abstraction? You can't tell the difference whether a human being is a species or an idea. A human being is a fraction of mass, according to Marxism and socialism. That is why to treat human beings as impersonal makes it easy to treat them as trash. But God calls us by name. He is personal in relation to us. He called Abraham by name. He called Moses by name. He called Paul by name. He said to Moses that he knows him by name, Exodus 33:17. Let's take a far-fetched example. He said to Cyrus the king, who was not of his domain, I, the Lord, the God of Israel, who calls you by your name. Christ, the inspector of life, is coming to the tombstone of this world. We must pray for God to call our corrupt leaders by their name and summon them to change their ways. If he did it before, he can do it again. That's the end of my first point. Until next time, may the shalom of God go before you. Amen. Come and adore me.